Hey there everybody, welcome back to a brand new episode of Let's Play Undertale. So, first things first, you might be wondering, why I'm all the way back in Snowden? It just felt like dropping stuff off, picking up some items, and we're going back. So this is the river boatman, or woman. They are basically the fast travel between Snowden, Waterfall, and Hotland. It's the only reason I did this. Sometimes the boat is a little goofy. Like that. La la la, Temi Village. The room before the darkening lantern room. Oh, so he knows where Temi Village is. Interesting. Thank you, dog boat. You're our best boat. Come again sometime. Tra la la. Alright, so the good news is I can just take the elevator back. And yeah. I'll meet you back over by Mettaton's room. Alright guys, we're here. Round 20,000 with Mettaton. Let's try not to lose this time. Yes, we're gonna skip the monologue by turning you around now. What will you do? Skipperino, Pepperino.
Really? Where? Clever. Very clever.
Mettaton EX makes its premiere. Let's pose. Dramatically.
Lights, camera, action.
Dodge that leg, dodge that leg. Stop. Ow. Mettaton. Pose dramatically again.
Drama, romance, bloodshed.
Ow. Heel turn. They're rooting for your destruction this turn.
I'm the idol everyone craves.
Ow, ow, ow. Cinnamon bun. Issue is maxed out.
Smile for the camera.
Gotcha. Not this time. It smells like Mettaton. Act and pose.
Ooh, it's time for a pop quiz. I will brush keyboard. This is an essay question.
What do you like most about the Mettaton? He is a ghost in a bot body. Ghost in the shell.
Nice, you get a gold star.
Saving your essay for future use. Other pose.
Your essay is really good, everyone in your heart. But I'm not sure it's mine.
Hey, chill. Chill, Mettatoni. Oh gosh. If you like some Italian mobs, you'd be like a Mettatoni. That'd be funny. Alright, I got it. No. Yes. No. No. I should have boasted that turn, man. Smells like Mettaton. Boast. You say you aren't gonna get hit at all. Ratings gradually increase during Metaton's turn.
Ooh, I'm just warming up.
Not today. Not today. Oh my gosh, the ratings are nice. Pose again. The audience nods.
But how are you on the dance floor?
I just not move. I'll wait till the white one shows up. Buy him. Buy him. Buy him. Buy him. Alright, I'm gonna boast again. This is a ballsy move. Rating scheduling increased during Mettaton's turn. Can you keep. Ow. I already goofed it up. I should have moved. Boast.
Lights, camera, bombs.
Not today, Mettatoni. Heel turn. They're rooting for your destruction this turn.
Things are blowing up.
Not this time, buddy. Oh, God, he moves. You say you aren't going to get it all. Ratings gradually increasing, but it's on the turn.
Time for our union regulated break.
Happy break time. Wow. Perfect timing. He posed dramatically. The audience nods.
The drums are listened on. How about another heart to heart?
Oh, watch out. Oh wow, hitting the heart actually. Me. Points! Mettaton. Oh, he lost his arms. Turn and scoff at the audience. They're rooting for your destruction this turn.
Arms? Who needs arms with legs like these?
I'm still going to win. Ooh. Oh! I wasn't paying attention to my health. I'm a dummy! Alright, I'm gonna just get back to the arm segment. I'm stupid. I should have looked at my health bar. Man. Alright. I'll catch you guys back in a second. See if I can get back there. Mettaton. Alright, we're back here. Let's go ahead and pose. The audience dramatically nods. The audience dramatically nods, Anna.
Arms? Who needs arms with legs like these?
That's a better pose for life.
I'm still going to win.
Ow. Oh. Oh, hey. Okay, it was in rewind. Eat the cinnamon bun.
Come on.
I don't remember. Okay. Ooh, that was close. Heel turn.
The show must go on.
God. Ow. Yikes. On brand food, yes.
Drama. Action.
Oh, this is rough. This is rough. This is rough. This is scuff and rough. Rough and tough and scuff. Alright, there's all my healing items. I'm out of cinnamon bunny.
Lights. Camera. Enough of this. Do you really want humanity to perish? Or do you just believe in yourself that much?
Mettaton. Let's heal turn. Scoff the audience. They're rooting for your destruction this turn.
Huh. Inspiring. Well, darling, it's either me or you. I think the whole heart of note is going to win. Witness the true power of humanity's star.
Ooh. Whoa, chill with them legs. Back with them legs, Mettaton. Got him. Mettaton. Oh, wow. Despite being hurt, you pose dramatically. The audience applauds.
Then, are you the star? Can you really protect humanity?
Jesus, chill. I'm trying to spare you, my guy. That, you need to not try to kill me. Jesus Christ. I refuse to die here. I refuse. Mettaton. Heal turn. They're rooting for your destruction this turn. Ow. Ooh. Okay, ratings through the roof right now.
Ooh, look at these rays.
Oh god, that worked.
This is the most viewers I've ever had. We've reached the viewer call-in milestone. One lucky viewer will have the chance to talk to me before I leave the underground forever. Let's see who calls in first. Hi, you're on TV. What do you have to say on this, our last show? Oh. Hi, Mettaton. I really liked watching your show. My life is pretty boring, but seeing you on the screen brought excitement into my life, vicariously. I can't tell, but I guess this is the last episode. I'll miss you, Mettaton. Oh, I didn't mean to talk so long. Oh.
No, wait!
I'll take another call.
Mettaton, your show made us so happy.
Mettaton, I don't know what I'll do without you.
Mettaton, there's a Mettaton-shaped hole in my Mettaton-shaped heart.
Ah, I... I see. Everyone. Thank you so much. Darling, perhaps it might be better if I stay here for a while. Humans already have stars and idols, but monsters, they only have me. If I left, the underground would lose its spark. I'd leave a making void that could never be filled. So, I think I'll have to delay my big debut. Besides, you've proven to be very strong. Perhaps even strong enough to get past Asgore. I'm sure you'll be able to protect humanity. It's all for the best anyway. The truth is, this form's energy consumption is inefficient. In a few moments I'll run out of battery power and, well, I'll be alright. Knock him dead, darling. And everyone, thank you. You've been a great audience.
Mettaton. I managed to open the lock. Are you too? Oh my god. Mettaton, are you? Thank god, it's just the batteries. Mettaton, if you were gone, I mean, hey, it's no problem, you know? He's just a robot. If you mess it up, I could always just build another. Why don't you go on ahead?
It's out of batteries.
I just need a moment.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Let's keep going.
You have anything to say?
So you're about to meet Asgore, huh? You must be pretty excited about all that, huh?
Okay, Alfie.
You'll finally get to go home.
You wanna say anything yet? No?
Wait! I was just going to, say goodbye and... I can't take this anymore. I lied to you. A human soul isn't strong enough to cross the barrier alone. It takes at least a human soul and a monster soul. If you want to go home, you'll have to take his soul. You'll have to kill Asgore. I'm sorry.
Alphys, come back. Where'd you go, woman? I think you're on the floor one. Yes. There's no response. Open the door, Alphys. Okay. Let's push on forward a little bit. Please select the location. So we're gonna go right back to the throne room area thing. See what's going on there. Alright, so we're here. The elevator is in use. Okay. There's no response.
Yeah. Oh, I could... Oh, I'm stupid. I got dimensional boxes in here. I could have used my inventory the whole time. I didn't have to go, actually go all the way back to Snowden to use the boxes. I'm stupid. Well, for whatever reason, it seems like I can't actually do the ending I wanted to do. Whoa. Talk about Flashback City. This is Toriel's house. A long time ago, a human fell into the ruins. Injured by its fall, the human called out for help. You took a key and put it in your phone's keychain.
Asriel, the king's son, heard the human's call. He brought the human back to the castle.
Can you let me go? Thank you. The way is blocked by two padlocks. There's a note attached.
Howdy, I'm in the garden. If you have anything you need to get off your chest, please don't hesitate to come. The keys are in the kitchen in the hallway.
Ah, so I need the other key. There's a heart-shaped locket inside the box. Will you take it? Yes. You got the heart-shaped locket. And this one. There's a worn dagger inside the box. Will you take it? Hello? You got the worn dagger. Let's see. You equip the locket. Item, worn dagger. You equip the dagger. Room under renovations. Over time, Asriel and the human became like siblings. The king and queen treated the human child as their own. The underground was full of hope. Yes, I'm giving each one of these characters their own voice, or it's doing as best as I can. Second keychain. Oh. It's Asgore's journal. The current page says, it's nice today. The ink is still almost wet. It's a trophy. Number one nose nuzzle champs 98. Oh my god, the... It's a clothes drawer there. Robes, button-up shirts, and a pink hand-knit sweater that says Mr. Dad Guy. But no, so apparently the nuzzle nose champs must have been Toriel and Asgore. They're the ones that beat the two dogs. Macaroni Art of a Flower. For King Dad. Aw. It's a bureau. There's a Santa Claus outfit inside. Ah, so you're Mr. Kringle. Despite everything, it's still you. You unlock the chain.
One day, the human became very ill.
The sick human only had one request, to see the flowers from their village. But there was nothing we could do.
Vegetoids are so friggin' creepy.
The next day. The human died.
Oh.
Asriel, racked with grief, absorbed the human soul.
He transformed into a being with incredible power.
With the human soul, Asriel crossed through the barrier.
He carried the human's body into the sunset.
Back to the land of the humans.
I don't know why I said land, it's village.
Asriel reached the center of the village. There he found a bed of golden flowers. carry the human onto it. Suddenly, screams rang out. The villagers saw Asriel holding the human's body. They thought that he had killed the child.
The humans attacked him with everything they had.
He was struck with blow after blow. Asriel had the power to destroy them all.
But
Asriel did not fight back.
Clutching the human,
Asriel smiled and walked away.
Wounded, Asriel stumbled home. He entered the castle and collapsed.
His dust spread across the garden.
The kingdom fell into despair. The king and queen had lost two children in one night. The humans had once again taken everything from us. The king decided it was time to end our soul.
Save us all.
Every human who falls down here must die. With enough souls, we can shatter the barrier forever. It's not long now.
King Asgore
will give us hope.
You should be smiling too. Aren't you excited? Aren't you happy?
You're going to be free. Alright, let me save right here. See where this elevator goes. Oh, it just leads us right back here. Okay, I'm gonna try and check on the Alphys thing one more time, guys. Because if I don't get it, I'll have to end up running through the game again. At least I think I will. I'm not really sure how the whole pacifist ending into a true pacifist ending thing works when you beat the game. If I remember correctly, you have to beat the game once and then play through it again and, you know, befriend everyone. And I would like to do that on the first try without having to go through it all again. So I'm going to go check, because what was supposed to happen is the moment I entered this bridge right here, I was supposed to have gotten a phone call from Undyne. And from there, I could trigger the events that let me befriend Alphys. Okay, this letter is not what I needed. That letter just leads up to the brats. But either way, guys, I'll catch you all back in a minute. If it works, I'll go through that. And if not, you'll just see me cut back to the hallway that I was in where I saved. It's called Last Corridor. All right, guys, I'll be right back.
Oh hey, it's Sans. What you doing here, Chuckle Bones? What you want?
So, you finally made it. The end of your journey is at hand. In a few moments, you will meet the king. Together, you will determine the future of this world. That's then. Now, you will be judged. You will be judged for your every action. You will be judged for every experience that you've earned. What's EXP? It's an acronym. Stands for execution points. Ooh. Not what I was expecting. A way of quantifying the pain that you've inflicted on others. When you kill someone, your EXP increases. When you have enough EXP, your love increases. Love, too, is an acronym. It stands for level of violence. Okay, that's the exact opposite of what love means. A way of measuring someone's capacity to hurt. The more you kill, the easier it becomes to distance yourself. The more you distance yourself, the less you will hurt. The more easily you can bring yourself to hurt others. But you never gained any love. Of course, that doesn't mean you're completely innocent or naive. Just that you kept a certain tenderness in your heart. No matter the struggles or hardships you faced, you strived to do the right thing. You refused to hurt anyone. Even when you ran away, you did it with a smile. You never gained a love, but you gained love. Does that make sense? Maybe not. Now, you're about to face the greatest challenge of your entire journey. Your actions here will determine the fate of the entire world. You refuse to fight. Asgore will take your soul and destroy humanity. But if you kill Asgore and go home, monsters will remain trapped underground. What will you do? Well, if I were you, I would have thrown in the towel by now. But you didn't get this far by giving up, did you? That's right. You have something called determination. So long as you hold on, so long as you do what's right in your heart, I believe you can do the right thing. Alright. We're all counting on you, kid. Good luck.
Sans, hold on a minute. What the... Sans, where did you go, you ninja?
Ninja Sans. It's confirmed.
Alright, guys. I don't think I will be doing anything else in this episode. I was debating it. However... Oh my god, my dogs. However, the next segment is pretty long. You know, you're gonna fight King Asgore. And then there's, you know, all the dialogue post that. That's gonna be a nightmare. It's gonna take forever. So I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave the episode off here. If you liked today's episode, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, everyone. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Hit that subscribe button if you aren't already a part of the Curly Crew, and, you know, sign on up. That way you guys know whenever I drop a brand new episode. And most importantly, if you already haven't, follow me on Twitter. I drop, you know, updates about my videos in case you want to catch up on something like that. That's where I am too. So other than that, guys, I will catch you all here next time. This is the Afro Lad signing out, and I hope you all have a great and wonderful day.